shoulder width apart. And we're just going to do some of this. Apologies for the delay. I got parked on the A10 again, so I feel I'm going to have to bite the bullet and get the train. Oh, that's better. Right. Good morning, everybody. So keep going. Brilliant. So come forward a bit. We're breathing in and out. Yes, I am. How are we doing? Oh, good. So, just noticing the ground under the feet, feeling the head float, feeling the hip sink, breathing in and out. Just really feel your alignment through the body. And then just going to raise the arms. So I've got a couple of new movements that I thought we'd better try out, because this is fresh from last night. So notice the breath. Okay, let the arms go. We're going to do bounce and shake. So we'll whistle through the loosening today. And then we've got a something so brand new, I can barely do it myself. So I thought I'd better share, because I don't want you missing out, see? So you can be equally confused and it'll be great. So we're just doing that. We're doing bounce and then we're doing shake. So there's... And we're all breathing. Marvellous. Okay, and then back to bounce. Very nice. And then we go like this. So we just relax the elbows. So I think last week we were looking at the step back and repulse the monkey, weren't we? Okay, we'll leave that cooking for a week and do something else. Just to sort of... Okay, yeah, very good. So nice and relaxed in the palms of the hands. Okay, and then turn. We're opening the hands and raising them up. And you want to relax the shoulders a bit more. Very good. And we're all breathing. Four, three, two, one, change. One in front, one behind. Morning. So. You just really letting the arms go. Just let the arms drop and fold. I'll show you that from the side. Drop and fold. I'm transferring my weight. I'm turning the waist. And from the back, drop and fold. So. So feel the weight transfer. So you're transferring the weight and turning. Four, three, two, and one. Marvellous. Okay, posture check. So we're just going to check. Breathing. very nice. And then, there we go. Okay. Relax the palms of your hands and relax the wrists so you get lots of space in the hands. We're lengthening through the body, so the head's floating, the hips sinking, and you're gently breathing in and gently breathing out. 4, 3, 2, 1, change. So let go in the shoulder. Gently breathing in and out. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and change. So we're wobbling, very nice. So you want to sink your hips a bit more, sink your hips more, and we're, that's it. Relax around the shoulders. Transfer the weight slightly. Four, three, two, one, and stop. Very nice. So check your posture again. We're going to go into bow and arrow stance. So we're solid connection to the ground, and then we turn the foot out, and then keeping the gap between the heels, we place the other foot forward, and I'll just show you that for what it looks like from the side. So I'm looking forwards, I'm listening behind and above, and I'm going forwards and back. Forwards and back. That's it. See if I can remember this thing. Yeah, okay. We'll come back to that in a minute. So what we're doing, we're just going to look at what it looks like. We're building it from the ground up. So you sink back and turn, you sink forward and turn. You sink back and turn, you sink forward and turn. You sink back and turn, you sink forward and turn. You sink back and turn. So when you sink forward and turn, you're still staying upright. Have a look from the side. So I'm like this, I'm like that. Brilliant. Okay, we'll do two more. Back and turn, forward and turn. One more. Back and turn, forward and turn. We'll just swap legs just to make sure we're all on the same. So we're just going forwards and back first. Just the forwards and back gives you an opportunity to put your feet on the right spots. And we're sinking down. That's it. And we're breathing, and you'll be nice and tall through the head, sinking the hips. So now, we go back, we turn, we go forward, we turn. We go back, we turn, we go forward, we turn. Yeah? So, back, turn to the bent leg. Forward, turn to the front leg. Back, turn towards the back leg. Forward, turn towards the front leg. Fantastic. Have a little rest. Okay. Demonstration. So, you go like this. You go forward. And back. It's like you're making a figure eight. making a figure eight. Show it from the back. Back, forward, back, forward. See, I told you it was tricky, didn't I? Okay, put your right foot forward. I'll face that way. So we have our hands up that way. Now we sink back. We lift them up. We sink forward. Sink back. Forward. Back. Forward. Back. Forward. Like you're rowing you're doing a canoe. It's a bit, it reminds me of a canoe. You know, we might be. We'll have to go canoeing and see if it works. So, you want to relax your shoulders. This is quite hard work on your shoulders, you'll have noticed. Okay, trot with the other foot forward. So, we're doing a figure eight, kind of canoe style, but we're like this. You can see it's good for your brain, yeah? Very good. So this is fresh from last night. We did it last night. Show you that from the diagonal view. So I'm just going like this, and you want to be nice and loose. This nice loose feeling in the arms, and light feeling in the arms. And it's all in the legs and the waist. That's it, and we're all breathing as well. Fantastic. Okay, and then it gets very fun. Yeah. So then what you do is you lift the heel off the floor, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes. Oh, I'm doing this wrong. You're supposed to stay upright. Sorry, I got that wrong. You want to stay upright. You want to stay upright. So we're going through some rapids now. So lift the heel, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes, lift the heel, lovely, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes, once more each foot, lift the toes. Right, now we swap legs and we're going to try it with the lifting of the heels and the toes with the other foot forward. So we get ourselves just so. We relax our shoulders, we lengthen through the spine, and we own our space, very nice. So we lift the toes, lift the heel, stay upright, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes, lift the heel, lift the toes, lift the heel. Well done! Okay, if that wasn't bad enough, swap legs again. Now what we do is we lift the heel, bring the foot in. Lift the toes, bring the foot in. Yeah. It's right foot forward now, isn't it? But thanks for paying attention. Well done. So, now the right foot. So you lift the heel, bring the foot out. Start again. Hang on. That's it. Lift the heel, bring the foot in. Lift the toes, bring the foot in. Lift the heel. Bring your foot in. Lift the toes. Bring your foot in. Lift the toes. Bring your foot in. And if. So just do something, you're fine. And then that's it. Okay, that's, so we're going to try with the left foot forward now. Demonstration. So you lift the toes, bring the foot in. Lift the toes, bring the foot in. Lift the heel, bring the foot in. Lift the toes, bring the foot in. Lift the... You can see why I'm sharing this, can't you? It's really hard. And it's very good for the brain. Now slow down, don't be in so much of a hurry. So you can just do it like that. Nice and tall. And then what you can do, eventually what you do is you can do that. you can go for a little walk. So try that. Just try that one out, and then what I'll do is I'll check it with Mike to make sure I'm not teaching rubbish. So you just raise up and go, oops, down one, two, stuff. I'm still wonky. Those are the people that are on the computer all. That's a bit less wonky. So. It's sort of got similarities to Ever and Carell's flying birds exercise. Okay, have a little shakeout. We'll just do some basics just to kind of lull everybody into a false sense of security, and then I'll also throw another new one in, but it's nowhere near as tricky. So we just relax the palms of the hands. So I did a movement at the weekend. I was in Sheffield for a few days on a retreat, Tai Chi retreat. And on the Monday morning I was shown a move, and it reminded me of Happy Phoenix. We've not done Happy Phoenix for a while, so I'll do that because it's great. It's another one that's very good for balance. That's lovely. Okay, just check your posture. So you want to feel nice and tall. You want to be very softly gazing forwards as you listen behind and above. You're just opening the arms, and that's great. We are all breathing. Nice. It does help. So notice the breath as it goes in. Notice the breath as it comes out, and one strange thing Mike said in last night's class was, imagine you're breathing in through your feet. And I was like, okay, that's a bit weird. See if you can work that one out. Breathe in. Remember, you're relaxing the hands, you're relaxing the wrists. That's fantastic. Oh, okay, one more time. Relax the shoulders, and then we, like this. Oh. Parting the clouds, that's great. So we come up, open, and down. One more. down. Nice. So I really like this one. It's fabulous. It just, and then feel that rotation in the shoulder, and it's like a nice gentle stretch. It's a gentle stretch, and then you pull down using your hips. You pull down using your hips. You come up and down. That's great. Then one more time each side, that's wonderful. Okay, nice and relaxed. We'll just go back to this one again. And just tune into that. Keep going. Of the echo. So notice your waist. And we're breathing. And you want the muscles to feel, you're softening the muscles and allowing them to sink. And then the bones, there's this rising feeling in the bones. So we're just turning and we're looking, we're nice and tall. Okay, so now what we're going to do the first, we're going to do silk breathing, but just from the upright position. So we'll just go like this. Nice. Sink the shoulders, turn the waist. So you feel this nice circular movement. Two more times, and then relax, and then we go in the other direction. Wave hands like clouds. That's it, that's very good. So let's slow it down a bit. So we transfer the weight, and then as we turn, the hands change. We transfer the weight, and as we turn, the hands change. So, with that new exercise, I'll be able to talk more about the feet and what they're doing when I've worked it out and asked Mike, then we'll be able to do the feet in a bit more. I just thought, let's just do the move anyway, and we'll work out how it works later. It was so good. it's good enough for Corel, it's good enough for me. One more time, excited. That was beautiful, everybody. Fantastic. Have a little shake out. Yeah, why not? So, have a slightly wider stance. I'm just going to transfer the weight and turn. Transfer the weight and turn. Sink the hips. You're looking with your sleepy tiger eyes. Okay, hold the ball. Gonna do part of the wild horse's mane health exercise. So you sink into the other leg, open the arms. One, two, three, four. Yeah. One, transfer the weight. So you want to watch the alignment of the knee with the toes. Two, you transfer the weight. Three, you hold the ball. Four, bring the ball across. One. Two. Three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, one, two, three, four. One, two. So sink the shoulders. So the shoulders are nice and relaxed. One, last one. Two, three, four. Okay, and then for even more fun, one, two, three. Middle winding. Just do, it goes like this, then it comes around, and it comes around again. And don't worry if you're, just do something. And make your arms very soft. So last Tuesday, the way he was doing it, he was lifting his arm up really high, which I thought was a bit strange, but that's quite a nice little variation. Normally, he does it like this and keeps it all, yeah. Rather than trying to work it out, just join in and see what happens, and eventually it will kind of either come out or it won't, but you'll be more relaxed, so it's okay. So what we're doing is we're exercising both hemispheres of the brain, and even if you're doing a variation, and that's very good. Okay, let's relax. Nice, good effort everyone, that was fantastic. Fantastic, okay, have a little shake out. Right, so, next new move. So, make this shape like a flower. Like a flower. Nice flower. Yes. Make this shape, and then what you do, so it's like you've got a small peach, and then you've got a big peach. Now that's easy, isn't it? So let's do that a bit. Out, and I quite like it, it makes me feel quite happy actually, this one. So we did just this, but Evica Scuba's got a version of this where you go like this, and then you kick your foot, and then you come back down, and then you kick your foot. And this is called Happy Phoenix. Happy Phoenix. So, oh, you're all amazing. Look at that. Isn't this brilliant? So, this works your balance. So, you know, next time you've won the lottery or whatever, go, well, hey. So. Oh, it's like a chorus line. This is fantastic. There we go. Happy Phoenix. Whoops. Slightly wobbly Phoenix in my case. Don't worry if you've got a happy wobbly Phoenix, it's fine. Okay, one more time excited. Right, I'm gonna add that to our repertoire. I think, did you like that move? It's great, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, we'll add that to our tick list. Excellent. So, Happy Phoenix. Okay, let's do Uprooting Flowers. We've not done that one for a while. Uprooting Flowers and Taming the Tiger. So Uprooting Flowers, so next time you're in your garden, as an experiment, see if this works. You transfer the weight, you go like that, and then you uproot the flowers. Yeah. One, two. Fantastic. One, two. One, two. So these are quite nice movements. Two, one, two, one, two, one, two. So there is a video of that other move. I will study it and get back to you. Two, one, two. Two, and one more time. Fantastic. Okay, that was lovely. The next one is Taming the Tiger. So if you're taming a tiger, you want to be positive, you want to feel confident, and then they just go like this. So you just sort of like a round shape, you keep a round shape in the arms. Nice round shape, and you're tall through the spine, and you're using your sleepy tiger eyes. There we go. So it's like you've got a big steering wheel that you're turning. Turn the big steering wheel, that's it. You transfer the weight. Fantastic. Okay, shake out. Just bring the legs in together, bit further in together, and we just go back to wave hands like clouds. So we're just... So this bit happens after step back and repulse the monkey when you do the wave hands like clouds. So what we're going to do is we're going to practice the sidestep and mix it in with this movement, but we're going to do it separate. We're going to do it separate so our brains have a chance to, you know, relax a bit. You want to relax, you calm the mind. Calm the mind, regulate the breathing, soften the muscles. There we go. Okay, so what we're going to do, put the arms down. See you later, thanks for coming. You want to transfer the weight, bring the foot in. Then transfer the weight, lift the heel, step, heel toe, transfer. And we're breathing and we're tall. Sidestepping is another one that's very good for balance. We'll do, I've got room for one more, otherwise you'll be sitting down, won't you? You'll be sitting down. So, right, okay, now we're going to go that way. So we transfer the weight. Heel, the heel off, bring them together. Transfer. So it's almost like you drop into that leg, step out with your left leg, heel toe, transfer. Then this leg just lifts, just comes in, drop into that leg. Sink the hips, look through the sleepy tiger eyes. And we're breathing. That's it. Okay. And two more. And then for fun, we just start like this. We just start like this, get nice and soft. So the elbow is below the wrist. You've got a nice amount of space in the arms. So a nice round shape. Nice round shape, that's great. So it's like you've got a wheel. So one underneath, one on top. One underneath, one on top. You turn. One underneath, one on top. You turn. One underneath, one on top. We're breathing. And then once you've lulled yourself into a full sense of security, you then eventually it becomes part of the short form that we've been learning. Becomes part of the short form. And then once more, full fun. Okay, right. Now this time we'll stay here in the middle for a bit. Just to get that basic movement. So I've got this nice round shape. I'm turning my waist. This nice round shape. I'm turning the waist. And then we're going that way, just for a bit, just to back to the middle. Step. Of the wrist and you inspect the horse's mouth. So we'll try that. So we have your left foot forward and I'll do it sideways because then you can see what has it. So transfer your weight in the left foot, inspect the horse's mouth. That's it. Yeah. Okay, right. Now roll back and then that goes like that. So you've got the hand out like that, and you've got your weight in the back leg. Now, bring the right hand to the left, and that's a square shape. Ward off. That's it. Then you separate the hands, like you're taking a big glove off. Sink back, and double-handed push. And you push, that you've got nice sort of space, nice open space in the chest, and your shoulders are relaxed and you're sinking your hips. Right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show it flowing, and then we'll do it together flowing. But just so you can see, so demonstration, inspect the horse's mouth. I'll come a bit closer. Demonstration, inspect the horse's mouth, roll back, ward off, double-handed push. And we're going to do that four times. Because we've done it once, and then Corelli never liked to do things five times in total. So we're going to do that five times. And I'll, Okay, I'll turn the angle of these guys this way a bit, and maybe that'll be a bit easier for them. Right, so, here we go. Hold the ball, step into left bow stance. So we've got four more to go. Inspect the horse's mouth, roll back, ward off, double-handed push, hold the ball, transfer the weight, inspect the horse's mouth, roll back, ward off, double-handed push, hold the ball, inspect the horse's mouth, roll back, ward off, and double-handed push. Okay, once more with feeling, big ball, and then inspect the horse's mouth. Roll back, ward off, and double-handed push. Great, have a little shake-out. That was so good, we're going to do it with the right foot forward. I'll turn that round a little bit. Going to do that with the right foot forward. And then hold, step. Well, we'll do that five times. Inspect the horse's mouth, roll back, ward off, and double-handed push. Inspect the horse's mouth, roll back, ward off, double-handed push. Cool, you're all really good. See you next week. Thanks for coming. Four. Fantastic. And then once more with feeling, five. Inspect the horse's mouth. Roll back. Ward off, double-handed push. Right, and then have a little shake-up. If you need a sip of water, that's fine. I'll just move this back where I found it. So, let's... Great. Oh, well, that's handy, because we're not... Any questions on anything so far? I'll see if I can remember that foot exercise I did with Mike. Okay. We'd offer something for shoulders. Unstiffening shoulders. So we've got unstiffening shoulders. Anything else? Anyone more? Oh, you want to do that one? That one is really good for unstiffening shoulders. Dragon serves teacups. Oh, well, we should do it then. Right, we've got dragon serves teacups. That's all right. Just take it easy, because you've had some time off. Right. What we'll do is we'll do Dragon Serves Teacups, and then we'll do Plum Blossom, and then we'll very quickly do why take off as fruit? Because that's another one that's very good for shoulders. So we'll come back to the form at some other point. Okay, dragon serves teacups. So you start here, you turn. You sink back, and then you bring it all the way around, and then we go, oh, Brit, thanks for coming. See you next time. There we go. Marvellous. Look at that. Aren't we fabulous? There we go. And then that comes around. See? And don't worry about... Don't try and think your way around it. Try and do it. Just sort of join in. And it's basically... It's like singing the choruses at the folk club. You know, eventually you can sing the chorus and you don't even know how. That's that sort of idea. As soon as you start trying to work out Tai Chi, it just falls apart. So just enjoy whatever it is you're doing and relax. And it's all, there we go. Isn't that lovely? So this is a very happy dragon. There we go, there we go, there we are, marvellous. You all know it really. You're all doing it. One more time, that's fantastic. Fantastic. Okay, another one. Just shake out. That's good for the shoulders. It's everybody's favourite. Plum blossom falls left and right. So we're just going to do plum blossom falling left and right. There we go. And we come up. And then down. Keep breathing. There we go. And then, this is really relaxed. You want to be nice and relaxed. And you're right, Willie.
Yeah, it always worries me when you say keep breathing.
Yeah,
always worries me.
Well, they forget otherwise. I'd end up having to do all my first aid. Brilliant. Well, it's amazing what you forget to do when you're trying to get a move. And you just sort of... Fantastic. Okay, that was so wonderful. Very nice. We're going to do Y take off as fruit, but without the stepping. We're going to do the... You go like this, you transfer your weight, you open, so feel that shoulder open, then you close, just let that relax and it all floats, and then you sink your weight back, fanning out the hands, and then you make a round shape in the arms, you hold ball, dragon holds a pearl, then you bring it in, and then you go whoosh, like that, and then it changes sides. Marvellous, then we do it the other side, there we go. One, I'll do the counting, that might help. Two, three, four, oh, marvellous. Five, six, seven. Cat starts, tall fruit. There we go. And we're two, three, four. Nice. Five, six, seven, one, two, three, four. So soften the arms. Five. You're all doing it. You're all doing it. One more time. And then we'll try it with a step in for fun. There we go. Fantastic. Okay, then if that, you know, wasn't challenging enough for you, we then do it with the steps. So we'll go here, and then we'll just go for a nice little walk. So how to walk to the shops. So you step, park the wild horse's mane, open. So we just do a little bit, and then we'd better... Stop for a bit. Hold the ball. Sink the weight back. Sink forwards. Now step into cat stance. Step half the ball towards his mat. Open. Keep breathing. Sink. So noticing the breath as it goes in and out. There we go. Returning tall through the spine. Sink back. Sink forward very nice. Sink back. Relax the knee. There we go. This we'll do one more. So one more time. Yeah. Oh, this is getting better, isn't it? Brilliant. Right, that was so good. We'll stop right there. Come round in a circle. That was amazing. Ooh. So. So, go back to this one. So when you're doing any of these movements, what you want to do is, relax. So, we're just breathing. So, okay, put a foot forward. Just put a foot forward, and then we're just going to very, very gently and slowly do that movement, but without the complicated stuff. So just make the arms super, super soft. Super soft. And we're staying upright. So they're very, yeah, that's better. That's better. So you wanna soften and relax the arms. Especially when you're introduced to something new and a bit complicated, you want to make your first sort of, or at least a very early response, is to just relax your shoulders, soften the muscles, lengthen and breathe. And then try that on the other side. So put the other foot forward. Forward, that's it. And then we come back. Forward. And relax. Oh, we better stop. Breathe in. Sorry about that. I'll go on forever. And then we better get out of here sharpish. Sorry, Jeremy. I've been waffling on too much. Yeah. Okay. Embrace the tiger. Return to the mountain. I just looked up at the clock and it was like, oh my goodness, whoops. Never mind. One more time. And then polish your face. Give your back a rub. And then we'll do two more. straight together and bell. Good job, everyone. Amazing. Right, let's get out of here very quick.
Brilliant. By the way.